Hi, welcome back to my channel. Happy Friday. I am filming really early. It's about 6:20 right now. I have my front door open. It's gonna be really hot. So I wanna get the filming done, get started on my chores for the day before I have to turn on the air conditioning for me and Bruce. We're gonna probably go over 100 today here in Southern California where I live. Bruce is doing okay with his cancer treatments. As I said previously, I think he is almost in clinical remission, and he has an appointment in August to see his cardiologist as well as his oncologist. Bruce does have a grade 5 heart murmur as well as cancer. And then right now he's also dealing with allergies, which is affecting his face. So I've been cleaning his face and trying to stay on top of that, as well as giving his allergy pills. So I wanted to share with you today just a really quick look of my A5 5-year diary inside the, I think it's called Vacancy. I love this cover. This is my A5 cousin. And this is my writer's notebook, which contains my A5 HON hardcover. So let's show you this one first. My mom had an issue last week where she was sent back to the hospital. In here though, I've been using as my sketchbook, and I think about 2 weeks ago I was showing you what I was doing. See, I was kind of doing okay, and then I got stuck with the prompt for Power Rangers. That was something I did not watch in the 90s, and there seemed to be like a lot of characters for the Rangers. I decided to skip that one and go to the Care Bears. So as you can see for this one, this book goes from, let me put on my glasses, from 2023 to 2027. And there are a lot of pages in here that are blank. So let me try to flip through one, and everyone I'm showing you has something on it like this. So my intent was, on a page where I did not draw in the year of 2023, I would double up. Now let's go back to that. I would double up on my drawing for that year. So blank 2023. So here was also a blank page. But on this blank page, I decided to draw two Care Bears. Apparently there's 10. So what I did was, for the year of 2023, in parentheses, hopefully you can see that, I put 2024. I decided to draw the bedtime bear, and for 2024, I also decided to draw the birthday bear. So you can see what that looks like. And I thought these came out okay. I sort of wish, I don't know, I squished them together, because there's this space here that's kind of driving me nuts. But I also don't want to erase it, because I don't think I will be able to draw it like this again. So for now, I'm leaving it alone. Now this is where I stopped, because I don't think this Care Bear, and again for 2023, which I know that I drew in 2024, this one's called the Cheer Bear, and I just don't like the way it turned out compared to these guys. These to me look like a Care Bear. Then this guy. So I decided to stop for now while I decide what to do. So that was July 6th is when I drew him. And then I stopped. Now let's jump into the A5 HON, which I use as my writer's notebook. Here is the monthly layout. Here is my weekly. The washi tape I purchased from Jet Pins. This is for last week. I love the colors of the layout and how it turned out. And the week before, Coffee Monster Co. Finally got that name right. And then I guess we'll show you, in case you're curious, what a blank page looks like on a daily page for my writer's notebook. Let me try and find one. And here's a blank page of my writer's notebook. Would look like in the month of April. Didn't write too much, even though I sort of set it up in advance. Today's scene, what's next in that scene. This is my word count area, as well as keeping track of pages, of how many pages I may have written that day, the page that I started, page that I stopped. This is my word count increments that I like to do. Notes. So after I'm done writing, this is where I would write down if there were any issues that I had with my writing, anything I needed to research, anything like that, I would put over here. But let me just do a quick flip of this. And I only put the Yeti sticker on the front of the second half of the Traveler's Notebook so that I know where the front is, because there is no indication of what is the front and what is the back. So that's why that sticker is there. But here in the front, I keep track of my weight and steps. And the weight is in a colored column, which I use a highlighter marker to indicate. I still have this summer cold cough that I can't seem to get rid of. This is for this week. So my meals are over here, vitamins. This is a supplement that I need to take once a week. So I have that there. I keep track of my sleep. I started like a morning and nighttime skin routine. And then over here, I've been keeping track of my symptoms of my summer cold, and then trying to differentiate from the side effects that I've been getting from the supplement that I've been taking. And lastly, let's look at the cousin. Let's scoot these guys aside. So this is my weekly layout. I've been using a bit more of the Happy Planner stickers. The washi tape is Hello Kitty. I purchased that probably from Sanrio, as well as some Hello Kitty stickers that I found. This is for last week. And my voice is starting to go, so I do apologize. And then the week before. Now let's flip through the really quick pages of my daily pages. So this, I think, is where I left off last week. So Friday, so Saturday, we had my niece and her fiance through a party. So I decided to take up Friday to show the food. This isn't all the food that we had. There was more. There just was no pictures. But we had pizza, the birthday cake, some sushi that my sister-in-law made. This is their corgi. So sweet, so soft. Lots of fun. And then this is the family photo, my niece's photo, my niece and her fiance, which I obviously covered up. So this worked out really well. And for pictures, I use a Canon selfie. I also use their app to print out the photos. And this is how that turned out. So on Sunday, my husband and I went out for breakfast. My mom had a fall in late October. And so she's been recovering in a rehabilitation facility. So they had to call the ambulance to take her to the hospital. My sister arrived when the ambulance showed up. I went ahead and just put that picture, printed it out to put that in here. On Monday, there wasn't too much to memorialize on the page because we were still worried about my mom. And instead, I decided to put down some washi tape that my sister bought for me of Zootopia, as well as these funny little business card things, which we didn't know what they were used for, but I just thought I would go ahead and put that down on this page. On Tuesday, I decided to draw a hammerhead shark. It says the wide set eyes of hammerhead sharks actually gives them a better view field of vision than other sharks. They have 360 degree view of the environment because their eyeballs are right there. But I thought it turned out okay. This is a very rough watercolor sketch of a multicolored tree called the rainbow eucalyptus. It sheds its bark to reveal different colored bark. And I just thought it was really, really interesting. So I tried to draw it. It looked really easy to do using watercolor. Obviously, so I'm gonna call this is my abstract version of the rainbow eucalyptus. And for Thursday, I decided to write a quote that says, Mike Tyson once said, "Social media has made people way too comfortable with disrespecting people and not getting punched in the face for it." I found that on Strangest Facts on Facebook and didn't do any decoration. And then here's Friday, which I'm gonna probably do something later today after I get all my chores done. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you'd like to see after the pin videos of my Hobonichi. I hope you guys have a great weekend. I hope it's not too hot where you are. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.